what my board should be doing and what this organization should do to make it more of a national charter, the national charter that it is. And I said, great, Franco, let me go back to my board and talk to them about this, and they supported me, and the year after that, he created the first Leighton Grove, and he created that event as a gift to me, and I don't think Santa Claus has ever given me such a great gift, so I honor this Leighton Grove as a very special event for myself and all of us. My personal relationship with Franco, was something I thought I would never have to be sharing in public. He was not one of the people that I thought I would lose. I just didn't think that he would ever be, I would ever have to talk about my personal life with Franco in this manner of not being here. So this is a pretty tough one for me, because this award is usually such a wonderful, positive, happy award to give away, so bear with me on this one. Like many of you here today, Franco was a personal coach for me, a professional coach for me, my consigliere, you know, and my very dear, dear hometown friend. And I share that with many people. He guided many of us through some very challenging parts of our lives. You know, the Unsung Hero Award was created by this National AIDS Memorial to honor people who worked in the trenches, people that work behind the scenes. You know, people whose work had always gone unnoticed, but yet their impact, you know, touched so many lives in the HIV and AIDS community. And, you know, the theme of the year, of this event this year, with, you know, bringing the communities together, I mean, San Franco had done so much for the San Francisco community, not just the HIV AIDS community. He was a producer. He produced events. He encouraged so many talented people out there to work on their craft, and he highlighted their craft, and he made us all feel we were successful and valuable. You know, Franco was an artist. So, you know, when you think about Franco coming into an event or coming here and creating the group, he was an artist and this was his canvas. I mean, you know, how lucky were we all to have that opportunity to have him have him paint our picture. So the gifts go on and on for what Franco has given all of us. You know, Franco will be remembered in many ways, but because of this award, this Hero Award, it's a great award, and you know, he's a hero to all of us in the National AIDS Memorial Group, into our circle of friends. He's probably one of the greatest, you know, we're a family here at the Grove. So when we have, you know, when we bring people into our circle of friends, they're in forever, and the families are in forever, and it's a wonderful, wonderful thing. He will be, you know, we'll be eternally grateful for the way he lit the Grove, the way he brought us to a new position of hope, remembrance, and renewal around the World AIDS Day week and the events following. You know, it's a great honor for me to present this award to Franco's family, and I would like to do that. I would like to present this the Unsung Hero Award. National AIDS Memorial Grove Unsung Hero Award to Franco Beneficio, along with a state proclamation from Mark Lano. So it's Franco Beneficio ceremony.
Speakers that we've had here today, I am in awe of all of you, and this whole occasion, this whole event that my brother was honored to be a part of, and when Franco
was a part of something. He just didn't sit in the back seat. Kind of wanted to drive. So, on behalf of everyone here, I first want to tell you, Franco did not die of AIDS. He wasn't HIV positive. Franco died of stroke and aneurysm. And nonetheless, going suddenly, like a lot of people in this room, had friends and family go suddenly, way before their time. And when you got here in May, Family East met Family West. And it just bonded. And in this room, it's just one big family. And this... There's a common bond from all of us, and with all of us. And I'd like to thank, first and foremost, John Cunningham, one of the directors, Steve Sagerson, the board, Lauren Brown and AAA for bringing us out, Joel Stevens and Hilton Hotels, and everyone, everyone here that we've met, that we will continue to meet and hold dear in our hearts, for allowing us to witness his vision. And hopefully, his vision is like others said, is the start and not the end. And if everyone does their little piece, the puzzle hopefully will come together. So on behalf of Family East, Family West, this entire family, we want to thank you, San Francisco, for taking care of our little brother and allowing us to share this honor that we hold deeply. And may God bless you all. Thank you.